Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 25th of 2021, well, it is titled Planetary Nebula MZ3, the Ant Nebula. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a planetary nebula, and sometimes called the Ant Nebula for its elongated shape. And what this is an example of what happens at the end of the life of a star, much like our own sun. Now, when a star ends its life, it can do a number of different things, and most stars simply expel their outer layers out into space in a relatively calm manner. And that's what we would see here. That's what we call a planetary nebula, as material is expelled out into space. So the central star at the center of the Ant Nebula here would be a white dwarf star, a very compact star with most of the mass remaining, and but about the size of our Earth. So very compacted down, and in fact the material is crunched together as close as it can possibly be and still retain atomic structure, so that it can still be made up of individual atoms. And in fact you press the electrons as close together as they can possibly be. Now, trying to understand planetary nebula can be a challenge because we do get a lot of unusual shapes. So we would wonder and think in many cases that the material that would be expelled would be in a spherical shell. And here it seems to be being expelled particularly along one direction, so to the left or right of the star, but nothing going up above or below the star. There seems to be some reason it is being pushed in that direction. So it could be something to do with how the star spins, or its own magnetic field that may guide the gas following certain areas and avoiding others. Now, this is for every planetary nebula, because we do see some that actually do expand out into spherical shells. So it has to come down to understanding what the original star perhaps was like. And of course, that is difficult because we don't see a star turn into a planetary nebula. The time scale is much too long for us to be able to see that. So we see it when it is in the planetary nebula phase, and we see other stars like our own sun that will eventually reach this phase. But because stars evolve and change in such a slow manner, we never can actually watch them change from one to another. So we don't know what the original star exactly was like that formed this nebula. So that's why we still study and try to model these to better learn about this process, which is something that will happen in about 5 billion years to our own sun. So that was our picture of the day for April the 25th of 2021. It was titled Planetary Nebula MZ3, the Ant Nebula. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Black Hole Destroys Star. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.